Hello all, I'm Viru from electronicsinnovation.com. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a simple pulse oximeter at home by doing it yourself. This device will read SpO2 and heart rate data from MAX30100 sensor and display it on the OLED display. I'm going to use a conventional pulse oximeter like device for this project, which I made in one of my previous videos. But don't worry, I will explain you how to make this with just two cloth hanging clips and superglue, which are always available at home. Let's take a moment and thank PCBWare.com, the sponsor of the video. PCBWare.com is an online PCB manufacturing enterprise which produces the best in quality PCBs for just $5. PCBWare.com offers all services you need to make hardware for your IoT or embedded devices. If you have a similar kind of requirement, do check out their website for more details. The link is in the description below. Requirements are ESP32 module, MAX30100 sensor, OLED display, wearer boards, connecting wires, solder kit, and some cloth hanging clips. Circuit diagram. Here is the circuit diagram to interface MAX30100 and OLED display with ESP32 module. Since we are using I2C protocol, both modules can be interfaced with ESP32 with the same pins. After connections, the circuit should be something like this. Don't worry, I will guide you step by step to make this arrangement in the next few minutes. If you are not interested to make this kind of arrangement, you can skip this part and you can still use the breadboard to connect the device as shown here. Let's see how to make this device. The idea is to replicate conventional pulse oximeter. Why? Because it will be very easy to measure SpO2 and heart rate by just plugging onto the finger. We are going to achieve this by soldering MAX30100 inside of these two wearer boards and OLED display on the top. Similarly, ESP32 will be soldered on the bottom of the pulse oximeter. First, solder MAX30100 on one side of the wearer boards. After that, solder two pull-up resistors. If you want to know why do we need to solder external pull-up resistors, follow the above I button. After soldering of pull-up resistors, place the ESP32 on the other side of the wearer board. Now connect the I2C data pins SCL, STA and power pins VCC and ground pins of the MAX30100 with ESP32 respective pins. Take another wearer board and solder OLED display. Now connect the I2C data pins SCL, STA and power pins VCC and ground of the OLED display with ESP32. Make sure you are using flexible wires for this connection, otherwise the wires will break like this. After using flexible wires only, I can make the connection with second PCB. After connections are done, take two cloth hanging clips and place them between the two wearer boards as shown here. Then stick both wearer boards with clips using super glue. Make sure the super glue shouldn't touch any connection. If so, short circuit will happen, so take care of it. Finally, the pulse oximeter device is ready, which we made just using components available at our home. I would like to make this device battery operated, but currently I don't have stock of small battery packs. I have already ordered few batteries, but due to lockdown here, the delivery is getting delayed. So for the time being, we are moving forward without batteries. Now it's time to program the device. Here is the code to read data from the MAX30100 sensor and display it on the OLED display. Before you upload the code to ESP32, make sure you have downloaded all the required libraries. These two libraries are not available on the Arduino library manager. You have to download them from GitHub and then install using the add zip library feature on the Arduino IDE. The complete code and links for the libraries can be found on the project page, which is mentioned in the description below. Connect the ESP32 with laptop and select the board type ESP32 dev module and write port from the tools menu. After that, click on uploading button. After successful uploading, you can see the program in action. Just plug in this module onto the finger and measure SpO2 and heart rate of your body seamlessly. So, this is how you can make a simple pulse oximeter at home by doing it yourself. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Stay tuned to Electronics Innovation for more innovative projects. See you on the next innovative project. Bye bye.